Hello, boys and girls. I am going to show you a regular room at Treasure Island, the Treasure Island Resort TI in Las Vegas, which is on the strip towards the north side, but still well center strip, really. Center north, so to speak. The room is 4077. It's on the fourth floor, and it's a non-connecting room. Now, as you can see, the corridor is pretty plain. I've just come from Caesars. And of course, it was the Octavius Tower. It was really grand, quite enjoyed actually. But this is more modest, of course. I had to pay for this one. It wasn't comped. I rarely come to this resort. But it was an offer, and it was free buffets, and two free buffets, and for a decent rate. Now, you're going to be, this is a slightly, in my opinion, slightly, well, you can check for yourself, slightly bigger room than the regular room that is connecting. Because in my opinion, you've got just a few inches more in a specific section of the room, and I'll show you. Pros and cons, large enough bathroom. Oh my God, I'll miss that size when I'm at Mirage. And then, of course, there are some cons. And be prepared, although I do have a strip view, because I specifically wanted a non-connecting room, and I checked in really early. I was given a room on the fourth floor, and I accepted it. So here we go. Now, why did I ask for non-connecting? I just don't want to hear neighbors. I don't want to hear other people's noise. I'm the older I get, the fussier I get. And, you know, I was fussy when I was 17. So can you imagine what it's going to be like now? And I'm not even that old. Let's start. Okay, let's start with the bad points, which are that the wardrobe is so small. Okay, look at that. Small for a tiny space, just barely one suitcase. If you change the way it's positioned, a big suitcase, but that's it. Very small space for anything that it's long in terms of clothes. And then you have another section. Oh, another section with the safe and the fridge. I'll show you. See, this is from the other side. Now, this mess is not mine. This is my travel companion. You see? That's messy. So, okay, a safe, which is a decent size, nothing outstanding, but you have to put your computers flat, which is good. It depends how fussy you are. Sometimes I don't like to put weight on my computers, but it's a regular size, nothing, you know, it's big. It looks bigger than it is inside for obvious reasons. And it's small. I mean, closed section is quite small, actually. And okay, now let me show you the room. Forgive the mess here. Usually I don't have the suitcases in the room, but I checked in so early, and as you can see, I don't have much space. At least they give you two luggage racks, which is more than most other places where you have to ask for extras. So it's a little dark because it's nighttime, and this is it. Everything that I could light up, it's lit up. Two beds, which is nice. I like it when I have the option. Sometimes these days you have to pay extra for the additional bed. I understand the reason behind it. That's fine. I'm not complaining. I will tell you the quality of the sleep that I've had tomorrow morning. I like to actually sleep on it as opposed to try it, because one thing is to try, one thing to sleep on it. So at the end of this video, I'll tell you what the mattress was like and what the quality of the sleep was like under all aspects. And here a little, see? Okay. Sometimes I just should not say anything, should I? Okay, and the same thing, what I'll also do as an addendum, I will actually turn the TV on and go through it and let you know later what it was like. And I'll also let you know later what the Wi-Fi was like. And when I mean later, I mean as at the end of this video, I'll just attach it. I'll attach the end, the addendum at the end of it. Okay, I've said the word end too many times. I've just come from the buffet, and I always feel drunk after the buffet, and then I feel drunk when I check in, and I never drink. So this is the fun part. This is Vegas. Now, as I said, I'm on a low floor, so beware, but it is facing the strip. So if you actually were just higher up, you'd have a nice view. Can you see? Oh, you see me now. Isn't that pretty? Well, I turned one light off, but still not perfect. Nonetheless, you know, and that's the horrible stuff here at the bottom. But if you go high up, really, you will enjoy it much more.
As I said, I compromised. I liked early check-in and the fact that it was non-connecting. This time was very important for me. This is it. It's not nowhere near as big as the room that I had at Caesars, of course, Caesars Palace, except for one tower, the two towers, meaning Palace, Augustus, and Octavius. So the three towers have really large rooms. I love it for that. But of course, this is just standard. And for Europeans, this is going to be way big enough. It's going to be really big enough. Have you seen some European hotel rooms? You can barely get in. You probably sleep standing most of the time. But here for Vegas, this is a standard size, but it's a nice size. I don't feel cramped at all. Although I really have a lot to say about that tiny wardrobe. If two people had clothes and they actually wanted to hang them up, I don't think you'd have enough space. But I suppose most people just leave them in their suitcase, so it's okay. I'd like to try the TV right now, actually. Let me see. Okay, so the quality of the picture is good. The channels change at fastidiously slow, annoyingly slow pace, but it is pretty much the norm at regular average resorts in Vegas. For speed, you might have to go higher end. I had great TV stations and TV quality in terms of response time at Encore. But anyway, it's okay. You've got a regular amount of channels. If there is something extra that I need to say, or if the service wasn't as good as it seems and so forth, I will tell you at the end of this video. Nonetheless, as I'll tell you anything about sleep quality and so forth, nonetheless, the one thing I wanted to say, actually, and I will squeeze it in with this room review. Oh, I have to show the bathroom. So just stay tuned for a second, is that it is winter. And you know we pay resort fees, which is phenomenal. And they have a closed pool. And it's a sunny day. And that is infuriating me because, for example, Caesars Palace, they have lots of pools and one was open and so will be the same at Aria and some other resorts. But Aria certainly has an open pool. You know, all you have to do is heat it up. It's not that much to ask. When you are spending a fortune on resort fees and we spend the same resort fee as a guest that stays in the summer, therefore, I think we should somewhat complain if we don't find an operational pool, because we should get a reduction in resort fees because only half of the amenities or a section of the amenities are available. Think about that, guys. Let's just become a little bit fussier. You know, they're not bleeding debt, are they, these places? So I think just opening up the pool should be, even if they don't heat it up, at least allow your guests to sunbathe. Just throwing it out there, because I did see people swimming at other pools that were open, which means that it is doable, and I'm not even wearing a coat. I'm wearing nothing. I'm wearing my long sleeve top, and not that cold at all. And by the way, I have a section talking about Vegas weather on top-buffet.com if you want to know. Okay, so the bathroom, although nowhere near as large, say, as at Caesars Palace, it is of average size. It's a decent size. I'm comfortable, very comfortable with this size. It's in decent condition. It's kept its original beauty. You know, TI or Treasure Island has passed so many management hands or ownership hands that I no longer know who owns what and what they're doing to this place. So I don't know, you know, I mean, I'm going to try and close the door. You got a vanity mirror here, and it'd be nice if it worked, and yes, it does. And you have a shower bathtub of decent size, although it's not, of course, it's not a jet jacuzzi one like you had, for example, like I had at Caesars Palace. But what I notice here is that the water pressure was good, which was not at Caesars Palace, by the way. For some of you that wonder if these bathrooms have vents that work, none of them do. They've completely stopped that feature. At least it feels that way. There is no switch for them. They just were abandoned a long time ago. And I don't like that, because if you don't have a window that you can open, it would be nice to have some sort of a fan system. But they have that on top. Can you see it? The chute, so to speak, or the exit. But I don't know if it's operating. I know nothing about it. It doesn't feel like it, but it's the same at every resort, so, or almost every resort. But the bathroom is of a nice size, and you know, some other comparable resorts don't have a bathroom this size, so that's pretty good. But this is it. I mean, I think you'll be fine. I think it really depends on how much you've paid for this. I actually booked here because I wanted to review the buffet and I wanted to review this resort because it's been a long time since I last reviewed it. And I think I'm going to enjoy it. It feels good, but I will tell you later after I slept on it one night. So guys, if you have any questions, and girls, if you have any questions, ask me on top-buffet.com. And forgive me if there are some delays. When I travel, like for example, I'm traveling, I really don't have time to log on. It seems strange, but I'm out all the time. And at night, I literally collapse. So I just do the very basic, like check my emails and that's that. And then I have to edit the videos and so forth and then write all the updates. So forgive me, bear with me for a while. Sorry for the delay, but I will reply to all of your questions there. On this channel, if you're watching from YouTube, I may not reply. I just don't have enough time. It's just, this is a labor of love for me. So as you can imagine, it's not like I have 24/7 in terms of time. Nonetheless, I hope you have found this useful. Oh yes, I wanted to show you that what I think this is making it slightly bigger, but correct me if I'm wrong and I say bigger than the regular rooms, because it looks like, oh, there is a section. You see when it just, there is just the extra few inches here and here, rather than being a straight wall. And last time I was here, if my memory serves right, the room was just that little bit smaller because it was a straight wall as opposed to that indent section. Hello, guys and girls. I promised you an addendum, and here it is. So in terms of sleep quality, it was absolutely fine. The mattress was not, you know, high-end, super plush pillow top, but it was good enough, and I suspect it's some kind of a pillow top, although as you well know, there are different kinds and different qualities, but it was fine. The problem that I had was the air conditioning unit. It does not have a thermostat. It's like old-fashioned, as you can see, and it was practically impossible to regulate it. And now, being in the middle of the day, even if it's turned down to cool completely, it's still not cooling enough. So I wonder what it's going to be like in the summer when it's really, really hot. Nonetheless, it was a little bit dodgy keeping it at a temperature that I found super comfortable. It's much easier if you do have a thermostat, but that's something you may or may not be interested in, but I'll let you know anyway. And one final thing, just a second. And one final thing, I kind of mentioned it yesterday, opening this wardrobe section is a little dodgy. It's up here. You could actually injure your fingers. But it's just not the best. It's very small. But more importantly, I wanted to tell you that you do have a fridge here, because yesterday I didn't mention it to you. Just below the safe, there's a small fridge, and that's actually really, really handy, and it's a rarity unless you stay at places like Signature or Vodara and so forth. Regular Vegas resorts do not provide a fridge because they hope that you're gonna buy drinks. And some people bring their own coolers, but it isn't the same, is it? So that's a plus side. Now, because it was really quiet, it's a quiet, low traffic time, I heard absolutely no noise from the outside. But I suspect that when it's really busy, things may be different. So this is it. There are things that I want to tell you with regards to my experience here at Treasure Island, which was not all that great, about certain aspects that you may actually need to know. And I'll write about that on top-buffet.com. I'll put a link here as well. And then there is a positive aspect to it, and I have a mini video on that, and also I'll talk about it on top-buffet.com. Okay, guys, see you there. Bye-bye.